In this case, we have four tachometers from four unrelated sources. We have a tachometer from a combustion engine, we have two tachometers from two different electric motors, and then we also have the tachometer from the drive shaft. Let's take a look at some color maps. All five of these color maps are identical. If we zoom in on one of these color maps, you can see that there is order content that's not all linearly related. So let's click and drag to zoom in here. You'll see that if we zoom in really close in frequency, we have some order content here, which doesn't seem to be related to this order content kind of coming out radially. And then we also have these switching frequencies down here in these V shapes. So to get this order content to look a little bit more recognizable, what we can do is we can switch the tracking parameters to those four tachometers that we were just discussing. So I'll switch this first tachometer to that ICE engine. This one I'll switch it to be the drive shaft. This one will be one electric motor, and this will be the other electric motor. Now we can come in here and add processing cursors like order cursors. And if I zoom in really close in frequency, you can see that these orders line up now, and they're all radiating out from the origin. So I'll set this on second order. And the cool thing is that I can take this order and drag it into my color map, and if I drag it to this specific lower left-hand corner area, I'll get this label on my cursor that says function, and then when I drop it into the map, it'll add that order line in black, and I'll zoom in so you can see it a little bit better. So now that order, which previously was going to be difficult to trace because it didn't radiate out of the origin, it's now easy to trace with this order section. And of course, I can move this cursor around on my color map, and it'll trace in the other color map. So let's do that with a couple other functions. I'll zoom out on my overall color map, and I'll drop in an order cursor here. And just by dropping in this cursor and putting the function into this overall color map, we can kind of see what shape it's going to take. And we can move it around in this individual map until it lines up with something of interest on the overall color map. So maybe right here. And I'll just repeat this process, finding sort of the biggest contributors in all these little maps. And of course, we can also add a switching frequency cursor. So I'll add a standard order cursor, but I'll double-click on it and set the frequency offset or the switching frequency. And now I can drop that into my waterfall, and it'll line up nicely. So the benefit here is even though we have order content from lots of different uncorrelated sources, we can still drop in these order overlays and get a good understanding of what the major contributor for each of these orders is.